Hi friends, welcome to Competitive Exams Material channel. In this video, I am going to explain how to create a thread in Java. Okay, especially we are going to see how to create a thread by extending a thread class. So before jumping into how to create a thread, let's see a simple basic definition of thread. So thread is nothing but it's a separate path of execution within a program. Okay, thread is nothing but separate path of execution. Thread is a separate path of execution within same program. That means it's a separate flow. To increase the performance of our program or to increase the execution time of our program, we'll go for multi-threading. Okay, that means we'll go for the thread concept. One second. So there are two different ways to instantiate and start a thread or create a thread. So first one is by extending thread class and by implementing runnable interface. So these are the two different ways where we can create a thread. So by these two different ways we can create a thread. By extending thread class and by implementing runnable interface. So let's start into the program how to create a thread by extending the thread class. Just I'm creating a new package. Threads. And I'm just saying it as my thread. Okay, I'm just naming it as my thread. So in this my thread, first thing what we need to do is whenever we are creating a thread, okay, first we need to have a class which extends thread. So first thing is create a class which extends thread. So this is the first and foremost thing. And inside this, whenever we are extending thread class, here we'll be having an important method. So for a normal Java program, as we have a main method, which is the execution or heart of the program, in the similar way, we'll be having run method in the thread. Public void run. Okay. And here mention it as int I equal to 0, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus, system dot out dot println. So I am in child thread. I am just saying it as I am in child thread. So public class my thread extends thread public void run for int I equal to 0, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus system.out.println, I am in child thread. So this is the my thread class and this is the run method. So whenever we create a thread and call the start method, this run method will get executed. Okay. So I am creating another class called thread demo. Okay, another class called thread demo. Here what I am doing it is I am writing a main method. Okay, so first we have created a class, we have created a class and extended it to with thread class. So just see java.lang.threadclass. So what is a thread? It is a thread of execution within a program. The JVM allows an application to have multiple threads of execution running concurrently. So we use threads where in multi-threading. Every thread has a priority. So threads with higher priority are executed in preference to threads with the lower priority. So we'll look into the thread priorities in the next session with details. So for the time being, so this is what the java.lang.thread does. So how do we create a new thread? Just call it as my thread empty equal to new my thread empty equal to new my thread, or just say my thread t equal to new my thread. Okay, so when we call t dot start method, what when we do t dot start method, we'll see what the start method does. Okay, so public void start, this is the signature of the start method. So public void start, it doesn't have any arguments and it doesn't return anything. That is the signature of the public void start. Why? Because okay, in interviews people might be asking, I mean, what is the return type of the start method? Okay, what is the signature of the start method? Okay, so what the start method does, this causes the thread to begin execution. So thread execution or the thread start begins at when we call start method. So when we say start method, what happens is JVM calls the run method of this thread. Okay, so JVM will call run method of which thread? This my thread. Run method will be, okay, this my thread, one second, this my thread run method will be called when we say start method. So internally it calls the, so when we call start method on this my thread, it will go and call run method. So in order to, so what is the basic thing? So run method implementation is mandatory, okay, in order to start a thread. Okay, this is the one important point which you need to note. And the result is that two threads are running concurrently, the current thread which returns from the call to the start method and the other thread which executes its run method. Okay, so here these are the two important points we need to make note. So first is, so whenever we are calling, I mean whenever we are running this program, two threads will be executed. One is main thread, we call it as an main thread. Okay, main method will spawn a new thread. Okay, and the other thread is this my thread. Okay, let's run the program and see the output. Run as Java application. I am in child thread. It repeated 10 times. So when we call start, what it internally does, it will call run method. Okay, the start method will be calling the run method. So what is the signature of this run method? Public void run, public void run. Okay, when we call t dot start, it will call run method on this. Here we have different cases. Okay, so hope you understand. So far we are clear, right? So now we'll see what are the different cases while creating a thread, or while we need to consider. Okay, suppose if I am creating multiple threads. Okay, so we are not sure which thread get executed first. Suppose if we have multiple threads, right, what happens? We don't know which thread will be executed first. It all depends upon the thread scheduler. So thread scheduler will allocate CPU. Okay, we cannot decide, I mean, or as a programmer we cannot decide which should be executed first. Okay, then we have multiple threads. So we cannot expect the exact execution order and the execution output. So that is the first point or first case. And the second one we need to understand is difference between the start method and run method, the start method and run method. So when we say t dot start, a new thread will be created which is responsible for the execution of run method. So what the start will do, it will call the run method. Okay, and suppose if we try to call the run method, what happens? Suppose if we directly say instead of t dot start, when we call t dot run, what happens? I am just commenting this. Do we get any compile time error? No, we'll not get any compile time error. At the same time, we'll not get any runtime error as well. So when we say t.run, what it does is, so it's like a simple method execution. So it go and calls this parent I equal to 0 I less than 10 I plus plus 10 times. So it's like a simple normal method execution. When we say t.run, so what happens? It will not create a new thread and it will not run in a separate thread. Okay. So what it does is, so main thread will only t.run, right? It will not execute as a separate flow or separate independent path. Okay. So entire output, whatever we are getting now, suppose if we execute this program, we'll get the output, similar output as we got earlier. I'm in child thread, we'll get like that. So the entire output is produced by this main method only. But if we call t.start, right? So what happens? It will create a separate thread. Okay. And then it will execute run method of the particular thread. And then third point, importance of thread class start method. Okay. This is the third important case, which is thread class start method for every thread. So the important or mandatory activities are like registering the thread with the thread scheduler. Okay. And then invoking or calling the run method. So how does this how do we register a thread? So register a thread with the thread scheduler is done with the help of start method. This is first point and it calls run method. So both the activities are done by this start method. Okay. So without executing this t.start, there is no chance of starting a new thread in Java. Okay. By when we extend the thread class. I'm just removing this. And now, as I told you, when we extend thread class, it internally calls this run method. Suppose for assume that I'm not overriding this run method. What happens? Okay. If I am not overriding this run method, will it give any exception? So now what happens is when we say t.start, so what it happens is first it will check whether there is any run method in our my thread class or not. If no run method is present, what it does is it will call our super class. What is the super class? Thread class. It will try to execute thread class run method. So, but in thread class, what is the problem is we have a run method without any implementation. So we will not get any output. Suppose if you see, I executed this program and see whether we got any output or not. You see, we don't see any output. Okay. So that means we don't get any compilation error. We don't get any, runtime error. Okay. When we don't override run method, it calls, okay, thread class run method. It is highly recommended to override run method. Otherwise, there is no point in going for the multi-threading concept. Okay. And the next important point to make note is, suppose if I am trying to overload run method. Okay. Hope you know, right? What is overloading? Overloading is nothing but having the same method name, but having different arguments. Okay. We call it as an overloading. Here I am saying what? System.out.println. Okay. I am in run int i method. So when we say thread.start, what happens? Whether it will call this run method or whether it will call this run method. So when we say t.run, what happens is, it will call only run method without any arguments. Okay. We can overload run method. We'll not get any error, but thread class start method will always invoke no argument run method. Okay. If we want to call this run method with integer argument, what we have to do? We have to explicitly call from this main method. Okay. We need to go and call t.run. Then only we'll get that output. Otherwise, no one will call this run method. Okay, no one will call this run method. So let's run this program and test. Run as Java application. I am in child thread. Do you see here any output like I am in run init int I method? No, right? Okay. So this is how this is the overloading concept, and this is one of the important point while creating a by extending thread class and by run method, right? This is one important point to make note of. And the next one is overriding of start method. Okay, overriding of start method. Suppose if we are overriding a start method, so when we say t.start, what happens? We are calling the thread class start method, which internally calls the run method. But if I am trying to say t.start, first of all, do you see any start method over here? No. But how are we able to call this t.start? So when we extend this thread class, right? So in thread class, we have a start method, which internally calls the run method. That's how, this run method is called. But suppose if I am overriding start method, public void start method, and then I am saying sysout I am in start method, will this method gets called when we say t.start? So what happens is it will not call this run method, it simply calls this start method. It will not call run method. Why? Because we are overriding the start, which is present in the thread class. Thread class already has a start method. But when we say, when we override the start method in this MyThread class, what happens? It will not call thread class start method. So what thread class start method do? It will internally call run method. So instead of that, when we override public void start, what happens is it will be executing, our main thread will execute this start method. Let's run the program and see the output. Start method. So this is one of the important case where we need to consider. So in some of the interviews I have experienced this question. So what people will ask is, or what interviewer will ask is, can we call start method twice on a same thread? On the same thread, suppose if my thread T is there. So if we call t.start method, so what the interviewer will ask is, will it execute run method twice? What they will ask, will they execute run method? So what start method will do? It will call run method. So when we call t.start twice, will it call this run method? That's what the question is. So, but here what we need to remember, the important point. So when we call t.start twice, what happens is we'll get a runtime exception saying illegal thread state exception. What we'll get? Illegal thread state exception. Let's run the program and see whether we are getting that output or not. If you see, I'm getting illegal thread state exception. Let's clear and run the program. So if you see, we are getting illegal thread state exception. So first time what happens? Exception in the thread, though we are getting the output, we'll get exception in the thread main itself saying illegal thread state exception. If you want, you can see the documentation as well, Java documentation. If the thread was already started, we'll get illegal thread state exception. So this is how we create a thread by extending thread class. Hope you understand this video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to this video.